The first principle we talk about in the book is the idea of reimagining your business. And it's not just a buzzword. We really think it's really important to take a different approach to thinking about your organization, your business processes, and your business model in the company. AI impacts all of that, and you can't think about the industrial age ways of doing things anymore. And that's what we're talking about with reimagining. And we think it's really the third generation of organizations and third generation of the modern company when you think about it that way. And that's why it's important to think differently. The key to it is thinking about your processes in a different way. And your processes and your business becomes dynamic, personalized, and agile or flexible. And those characteristics are very important to think about and can allow you to do things differently than your competitors and advance your business, which is why we think it's important to get started now with AI so that you can be ahead of your competition. The other thing that I'd say is we found in the research that we did of 1,500 companies that those that are taking this reimagining approach are getting greater returns. And we talk about this in the book. The returns from companies that are reimagining are 2 to 5 times higher than the returns of companies that are just taking traditional approaches, which is why this new approach is important. I think we're moving into a world that I would call collaborative intelligence. I think sometimes artificial intelligence scares people or makes people think the wrong thing about AI. Collaborative intelligence means we take the best capabilities and unique qualities of a person, a human, and the best capabilities and qualities of machines or the AI and put them together. And by doing so, that's where these new types of jobs and new types of work come from, and that's really the future. It's really no different than what's happened in the past. I mean, how many people today use spreadsheets in the course of doing their work? You know, 30 or 40 years ago, people had no idea what a spreadsheet was and probably were, scared of desktop computers and the changes that was bringing on. AI is in the same way as providing us with new tools for us to work differently and think differently. That's why in the book, we talk about 6 categories of new jobs that are about this collaboration using human skills like perception, generalization, emotion, communication, combining that with machine skills like prediction, repetition, memorization, things that machines are good at. And that creates these new skills that we need to train people for. For example, there's a skill called judgment integration, which is how do you make a decision in an AI-enabled environment? It's a different way of thinking we need to train people for. And that's what we talk extensively about in the book. And there's 8 different skills that we outlined in the last chapter of the book that are the path to how you work together in this with technology in this age of AI that we're moving into. I think every organization needs to have a code of responsible AI, which governs how they apply AI in the organization to make sure that the right norms are followed. It has to have the right ethics. It shouldn't be biased. It needs to be transparent and explainable and understandable. There's a variety of requirements that every organization needs to think through and set their standards on. And not many organizations are doing that right now, and that's important. Organizations, I think, need a chief AI officer or somebody who's acting in that capacity to think about those types of issues, which is a big thing for some organizations to think about. Mm-hmm. And those are some of the things that organizations need to start working on now. But the one thing I'd say is we shouldn't expect the technologists to solve the issues of ethics and application of the technology, just like we don't expect the technologists of today or yesterday to solve all the broader societal issues. We need people who are experts in these domains, who are experts in ethics and related professions to understand the technology and bring that insight into organizations. And those types of skills are going to be more important on the business priority list as we proceed with AI.